Here I'm asked to graph this quadratic function, and quadratic functions, they graph up to be parabolas. I always like to find that y-intercept first. That's the easiest point to find. Okay, in this case, when x is 0, you can easily see the corresponding y-value is going to be 3. Notice here the leading coefficient is negative. That indicates that my parabola is going to open downward. But let's next find the x-intercepts. That's where we set y equal to 0. Doing that in this particular case, you get 0 equals negative x squared plus 2x plus 3. Now we need to solve the resulting quadratic equation. For me, it's really hard to factor these when the leading coefficient is negative. So I'm going to multiply everything by negative 1, and I'll have an equivalent equation, x squared minus 2x minus 3 equals 0. And then try to factor this. If it doesn't factor, we'll just use the quadratic formula. But it does here, 1 times 3 is 3. And then I'll have a 1x and a 3x. A 1x and a 3x adds up to negative 2 if the 3 is negative and the 1 is positive. And then a positive times a negative is negative. So it factors up nicely. X plus 1 equals 0, or x minus 3 equals 0, setting each factor equal to 0 and then solving. So either x is negative 1 or x is 3. So that tells me I have two x-intercepts, negative 1 comma 0 and 3 comma 0. X-intercepts are ordered pairs. The third step in the process is to find the vertex. Now we have a handy formula for the vertex, negative b over 2a. That's the same ab as we use for the quadratic formula. So in this case, a is negative 1, b is 2, and c is 3. So in this case, negative b, so negative 2, over 2 times a, 2 times negative 1. Okay, negative 2 over negative 2 is positive 1. That's just the x value. Now we need to find the corresponding y value by plugging that in to the original here. So plugging in 1, we'll have to negative x squared plus 2 times that 1 plus 3. Okay, be careful with the order of operations here. The base on the exponent is just 1, not negative. So 1 squared is 1, leave me with negative 1. Okay, you want to do that exponent before the subtraction. Plus 2 plus 3. Or 1 plus 3 is 4. Okay, so the vertex here then, as an ordered pair, is going to occur at 1 comma 4. Okay, so once you have the y-intercept, the two x-intercepts, and the vertex, you're ready to start graphing this. Okay, let me draw in a blank Cartesian coordinate system. Here I spent some time with the scale, making sure to have it so that I have negative 1 on the x-axis and 3. Those are my x-intercepts. 0 comma 3 is my y-intercept, and then here 1 comma 4 is my vertex. So you can see with the leading coefficient being negative that this is a parabola opening down. Let me connect the dots. Okay, so here it is. Notice parabolas are nice and rounded like that, opening down. But I also want to get that fifth point here. Let's look at the line of symmetry. The line of symmetry here is x equals 1. If you were to fold your paper in half along that line, you'd have a mirror image of the parabola. So that tells me for this y-intercept at 0, 3, we would have a corresponding point here at 2, comma 3. Okay, and that would be the fifth point that I'm after. Using symmetry, we have one unit here plus another unit. That's how we got that x value of 2. And there's the graph, the original function, y equals negative x squared plus 2x plus 3.